Namaste everyone. Today we are going to look at some movements that would help us to open up our hip, knees, and in order to able to sit in lotus position or meditation poses. One of our friends in our meditation group was telling that it's getting a bit difficult to sit in meditation pose a long time because of the sleeping sensation or numbness in the legs. Okay, so the truth is that ability to sit long develops over time. It takes a bit of time, maybe some months. So what we have to do is we have to train for 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, and regularly, slowly, we will get there. But most of the people, the problem is the flexibility. And when we look at this meditation posture for the lotus pose, the Padmasana, we have to take in consideration it is not only just the flexibility of the muscles. There are so many, all the tissues are involved. Muscles, bones, joints, ligaments, and all the body parts, all the tissues are, even skin has a big responsibility in sitting lotus pose. And not only the legs and the hips, we have to take consideration of our back muscles, the spine, because in meditation, it's not only the flexibility of the legs, it is the strength of the spine and the strength of the spinal muscles, the muscles that connecting vertebra to vertebra is very important as well. So we have to train the whole body to be able to sit in meditation. That is the reason in yoga we practice asanas, we practice physical exercises. In yoga we practice physical exercises not to make it stronger and muscular and beautiful. They're all secondary benefits, but primary goal of practicing physical exercises are to sit comfortably in meditation, in stillness for a long time. It is in that stillness that meditation happens. Okay, so we are going to look at some movements that we regularly practice in our daily routines, as well as some movement particularly focused on developing the hip joints and creating more flexibility in the joints, the lower joints. Okay, let's start. We come to the Parvatasana, like a hill, and keep on pushing the chest downward in order to open the spine and lengthen the spinal muscles. And we also work on our legs, the leg muscles, back of the legs, you know, you bend one leg and press the other leg. So you press the heels, you stretch the whole muscles, along with the muscles we stretch other tissues as well. Okay, so you alternatively move that. So two things you are doing here: one, you are extending your spine, another one, you are stretching the leg muscles. So I'm today just giving you some tips that you can practice on your own pace, and you repeat as much as you can, and slowly, steadily, patiently you work. Then you bring the right leg forward. Actually, you can sit in this posture as long as your body can take. You know, so not every body can sit here for a long time. Some people need a bit longer time to get some benefits. So you, if you can reach only here, that's fine. You breathe, then you slowly do work with your exhalation. Every time you breathe out, you bring your body a bit more forward. Because when our always, remember, I have told in many videos, every time when we breathe out, our body becomes a bit more flexible. During the exhalation, our body releases. Okay, at that moment, at that very moment of exhalation, we push forward. So you keep on pushing forward, and you see how much we can reach. Okay, that is one. Then you do the back stretch. You place the palms, then you lower your chest and head down. Remember, always you breathe. You can listen to me, but you breathe. Okay? And the breathing, if you continuously supply sufficient oxygen to your muscles, they will naturally become flexible. And you do not breathe, they will naturally lose the flexibility. Okay? So supply lots of oxygen into the muscles, into all the body parts. So that makes sure that every tissue is receiving new life. So they are not getting tense, you know. So it is like our mind, if you do not breathe, our mind becomes tensed. Then stress, anxiety, and all kinds of negative emotions and thoughts develop. So if you breathe throughout the day continuously, then you will notice that there is no anxiety and stress. So rule number that one, you have to remember that the cause, number one cause of stress and anxiety is our not using the breathing properly, or not breathing. We are not aware of our breathing. Okay, so that is what happens with our body. When they do not get a sufficient energy, new energy, continuous supply of new energy, they get into inflexibility. Okay, so then bring the palms down, you stretch. So once you learn these movements, please take your time, practice yourself. You relax, relax, every exhalation you relax. Keep your foot flat on the ground. You keep on pushing the knee downward, extend. And do not take your toes off, because there is a good opening in the hands and the arms. So we need even the ankle joint being flexible to sit in meditation pose. So relax there. Okay. Breathing a few rounds, giving time. You can always reduce the intensity by moving the knee forward. But our goal is to get more stretch and more length to the muscles. Good. Then the next one, again bring the right leg forward. Then you place your right palm on your right knee. We are going to open the knee to the side. We are going to open the right foot, sole of a foot of the ground, and open the knee to the side. But the left palm coming forward, and then the pelvis reaching forward. Then open it, push it away. Push it away, and you extend your spine. Then you twist and look over your right shoulder. That is a good stretching and opening for your spine, your hips. Breathe. Good. Come forward. And now we are going to do a classic pose called a Kapotasana, a pigeon. What you do, you place your right knee in between the palms. You know, many people can visually hear. I am aware of that. Please do how you can, wherever you are, and with respect to your body. And those who can, walk the left foot as much as you can and open your chest and head up. Then you slowly see. If you can stay there, you can choose to stay there. But if you can go deeper, you bring the arms forward, bring the elbows here. That's also very good. And if you can relax, extend your arms forward, drop your elbows, relax your forehead down. Again, breathing. So also you stay there, it is very relaxing pose you can practice. And if you want to go deeper, you bend your back leg, you hold it, then you pull it towards your buttock. You can hold it with your left hand, or you can hold it with your right hand and pulling the heel towards the buttock. That's a deep opening as well. Okay, so then you change, they bring the other leg. Push the hips up, heels pressing down, step your left leg forward. And now we are going to open the left leg. Move the left leg to the side, right arm forward. Lower your pelvis towards the ground, push the knee away from the chest, twist and look upward. Breathe. Good. Then you come forward, let us do the Kapotasana. The knee down, right leg back, see where you can reach, support. If you need a cushion to sit, and that's also a possibility, experiment with different things, roll the towel, whatever you can. I prefer not to put something very hard, because then the body is blocked there. Something softer, roll that, so the body weight will press softly, safely downward.
Okay, then you may lie down.
Extend. You can relax and breathe. A variation of a posture that we did before, you can lying down, also you can pull the leg. If you can reach, some people even cannot reach, maybe you can use a towel, wrap it around a strap, wrap it and you hold it, also a possibility. Okay, and that is also a good way. And now come back, you place your palms, support, lift your hips up, press your heels down. Good. Now we are going to focus on movements directly to focus just the joints, for the joints. Okay, you sit with the legs forward and point your toes forward towards your head. Breathe. And now rotate. Rotating the ankle joints. I would suggest that please practice sun salutation every day. Because sun salutation is liberating for the entire body. The whole body works in sun salutation. Now the opposite direction, circulate. You can do both feet in different directions, or you can do the same direction. You see, our intention is just to give a rotation to the ankles. So you see, both feet in the same direction, or you can do in the opposite direction at the same time. But don't forget which direction you have done on leg. Okay, so that is for the ankle. You do it every day. You can also do that standing. You know, standing up and down, rotate. In our future videos, we are going to do that. But because we are practicing for lotus, I'm sitting down and explaining. Yeah. Okay, so now for the knee, just move it up and down. Okay, so what I want to do now is rotating or creating, drawing circles in the air with your big toe. That gives movements and to the knee joint, all the tissues, the ligaments connecting to the knee joint. Then the opposite. Do it 5 times or 10 times in one direction, and the same in the opposite direction. But now change the other side. It's like a warming up. And during this practice, try if you can have your spine straight. So that's a bit challenging. If you want, you can, you know, cushion to sit up, please feel free. Okay, start from a very comfortable position. Now rotate. Good. Now let us do the hip opening. I sit like that for you to see better. You can place your one foot on top and press it. And some of you are not being able to do that there. So you can put here and press it. Okay, maybe a half butterfly. You can press it, press, press. You may feel the opening in there. If you can reach there, you know, if it is a lotus, is your goal, at least we have to be here. And if you can't even do this, your body may take longer time to reach here. Okay, then you do the same with the other side. Maybe some people can only reach here, you know. But don't get demotivated. Just keep on working. Even though you are not going to do the lotus tomorrow, maybe in a few months. But good thing is that you are opening and activating all the joints. The one reason people get arthritis is the lack of proper movements in the joints. Okay, so
thigh also with the foot on top of the thigh and press the knee down. Breathe. Remember to breathe all the time, all the time. Breathe, 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 breathe. You know, the breath alone can take a huge amount of your physical and psychological problems. Good. Now the whole full butterfly, you bring your feet together and bring the heels as close as you can, then clap. Okay, if you only reach here, that's fine. Clap. Okay, don't torture your body, please. Don't torture your body to get into any pose. Be gentle, be slow, grow slowly and steadily, patiently. Be patient and respect your body. Okay. And so if we can reach here, that's good. Okay, now we are going to rock the baby. You take one leg and you place that foot on the elbow. Okay, left foot on the right elbow. You take your right arm around and then you rock side to side, that open the hip joints. And if you feel like you can't bring your arm around, you just hold it like that and rock it. And every time you try a bit more in, you know, bringing it. So once you reach there, then you have to focus on opening it. Remember in one of our practice, we were doing the leg behind the head. We need not to go there. This is enough. It will open. And repeat the same with the other side. Again, find where you can. How we you can, then just repeat that. Good. These movements will help you accelerate the ability of your body to sit on in meditation pose. Okay, so now let's try the actual pose. There are many a meditation pose, not only lotus, not only padmasana is good for the meditation. There are many poses, but what is the importance? This is considered, the padmasana is considered as the most important posture in yoga. Most important posture in yoga, because when we sit in a lotus pose, it's naturally put the spine straight and erect, and that physical posture have a great influence to our mind. When we are sitting in lotus pose, it is difficult to get loose the concentration. So that is why lotus posture is most important. But that doesn't mean that all the masters, enlightened masters, were meditating in lotus pose. No. There are masters, they never used any. They only just sit how they felt comfortable and meditate. But they had a great quality that we don't have, and normal people don't have, is the power of concentration. Because for them, doesn't matter where the body is, what problems they have, but their mind is sharp and absolutely fixed, and there is no shake, there is no wind in their mind. So that doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if they have lotus posture or not. So for us, yeah, we need the body to reach there, and because whatever happens in our body is influencing our mind enormously. Okay, so let's start. And you can start here, and you can start one heel underneath, bringing the heel to the perineum, and other one on top of that. That's also you can try. If you need, use a cushion, sit. If the height of the cushion is not enough, you can fold it and place it underneath. And again, I'm reminding you, please do not use a block which is thick and non-moving, because that arrests your progress. It stays there. So instead, use a rolled or folded towel or a cushion that will press down. So when you begin, with your body weight, it will keep on pressing, and slowly it can go. And later you can reduce the fold of the towel or the cushion you are using. Okay, then you can try to take it out. Maybe some people may not be able to take it out in their whole life. Doesn't matter. It's important is that we train continuously so our body learns. Our body gathers good memory. Our intention is always injected into the muscles. So that is one way. And now we are at a sit, prepare for the lotus. If your posture is here, yeah, we need good support to the both thighs and to make it, make them comfortable. Okay, you sit there. And if you don't need that, you need only little, bring them to the knee. Okay, so maybe you don't need only one leg. One leg goes down well, only need another leg. That's fine. So always you have to study your body. You have to study the shape and position, the status of your body. Then you have to adapt. Because we don't have a single formula equally work for everyone. No, that is not the problem. That is not the truth. The truth is that we are all different. We are all different body. We all have different body and different experience. So we have to adapt according to our status. Okay, so some people having the problem is one leg comes and the other leg doesn't come on top. So where, what we can do, you can have sit here. You can train like that, you know, sit here with one leg on in the front and support with that. And we are going to train, and maybe it is better to use towels folder and one more layer on top. Then after some time, one more layer on top. You see how it is coming up? It's slowly coming up. And then you bring those closer. Then closer. And then you try to place it on top. I'm easily telling that, but this is all process of a long time. Okay, maybe a few weeks, dedicate at least a few weeks, or maybe a few months. Be patient. Good thing is every trial, every time you try, you are gaining, you are changing, you are transforming your life. Okay, and once you feel like it is comfortable, then you maybe stay there 30 seconds, 1 minute, 2 minutes. If you have got only 10 seconds, then you release it. Next day, 15 seconds. Even seconds are important. Okay, so I think you have a very good idea and some movements to develop your body to sit in lotus or sit in any meditation pose. Prepare. Very important is movement, because that physical movements ensures the circulation of energy in the body. If whenever the energy is blocked, then we start to experience pain. Okay, so I wish you good luck, and let me know if you have any difficulties and if you need any particular practice, or if you are facing some challenging in your meditation or in your yoga practice. Leave a comment and let us see if we can make a video. I have to remind you that we are starting training on a traditional yoga in ushapa.com. I will leave the link below so you can follow, join us, and the training costs like 70 cents a day or maybe less than 70, I think 60 something cents a day, because we want everyone to be able to afford our course. Everyone, we want to reach and help as many as people we want. Okay, thank you very much guys. I see you in the next video. Love you.